ஓகே வணக்கம் வணக்கம் ஜஸ்ட் கிவ் மீ ஒன் செகண்ட் கொஞ்ச நேரம் ஜஸ்ட் கிவ் மீ ஒன் செகண்ட் சிங்கப்பூர் அப்டேட்ஸ் சிங்கப்பூர் பிசிஏ அப்டேட்ஸ் ஸோ சிங்கப்பூரில் வேலை செய்கிறவங்களை வந்து கொஞ்சம் டேக் பண்ணிடுங்க ப்ளீஸ் எவ்வளோ பேரை வந்து டேக் பண்ண முடியுமோ டேக் பண்ணிடுங்க ஓகே சலாம் போஸ்கு சலாம் சலாம் வணக்கம் ஓகே இந்த அப்டேட் வந்து ஐம் கோயிங் டு மேக் இட் இன் இங்கிலீஷ் ஸோ தட் எவ்ரி ஒன் கேன் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் So I hope you all please do share. There's two updates. First one is about Singapore related updates, and the second one is about few other issues. Okay, first one is for those who are working in Singapore. Okay, lately you all are receiving on WhatsApp saying that PCA, you all have PCA approval. And you all can't go back into Singapore under PCA because of lockdown in Malaysia. Okay. Namba visaricha varaikkum. Okay. For what we have known that there's no such thing. There is no such thing. Okay. I've called Malaysian Immigration today, Custom. The Custom is going to be operating as normal. Okay. The immigration, the borders is going to operate as normal. They are not going to close down the borders. They are not going to shut down the borders. So the borders are going to be open as normal as per today's conversation. Seriya, I'll repeat it again in Tamil. Singapore JB உள்ள border வந்து இன்னைக்கு கடச்ச தகவல் படி இமிகிரேஷனுக்கு வந்து எந்த ஒரு தகவலும் கிடைக்கல அதை மூடணும்னு இந்த 14 நாள் லாக்டவுன்ல சரியா The immigration department have never received any orders from the government to close down okay so whoever who is going to go back into Singapore under PCA you all can still go back okay you all can still go back no issues daivu senji permask vandu whatsapp panni whatsapp panni whatsapp panni indha kelvi kekkadinga apdi unganaala pura mudiyadhu apdinu solli block vandhuchna kandipa na update pannuven seriya adhe kelviye vandu ketukittu irukadinga please do not ask the same question நிறைய பேர் வந்து அதே கேள்வி கேட்டுக்கிட்டு இருக்கீங்க யூ ஆல் ஆர் ஆஸ்கிங் மீ அபவுட் PCA whether you all can go into Singapore yes you all can go into Singapore but okay but today I have few cases people who are in Perak and people who are in Kedah okay they went to the police station they showed them the PCA letter that they have to go into Singapore one is going on the 6th And the other one is going on the 3rd. Okay. Police didn't give them approval. Okay. The police didn't give them approval for them to Rentas Negeri to go to Singapore. Okay. This is a issue. Okay. This is a issue because under PCA, y'all have paid $3,000 for y'all to go into Singapore. If y'all don't have approval to go into Singapore, y'all are going to have a big problem. Okay. So for that, we are fighting with PDRM right now. Okay. We are going to question PDRM. Okay. Because the lockdown shouldn't interrupt the process of people going to work into Singapore. Okay. Because they are not going to stay in Malaysia. They are going to go out of Malaysia. They are going for their job and they have paid about 11,000 to 12,000 ringgit to go into Singapore again. So it doesn't seem to be fair for Singapore government, for Malaysian government to stop this, especially PDRM. Okay. So please, PDRM, look into this. Okay. There's no any SOPs. By MKN, by Ismail Sabri, from stopping Malaysians to go into Singapore under PCA. Okay, so this is going to be an issue. Okay, this is going to be an issue. So please, if you are going to go into Singapore, if you are in PCA in Malaysia, in these 14 days of lockdown, if you all are going to go into Singapore, please don't wait until the day comes, go to the police station, if possible, 3 or 4 days before, go to the police station to get your approval to go to JB so that you all can go into Singapore. Excuse me. For those people who are having problem in the police station, please call us. Please call us. We will try to follow up. We will try to get MKN, because MKN is a department where we cannot call them. Okay. NATMA, we cannot call them. MKN, we cannot call them. They do not have any number. There's no way for us to talk to them. Okay. So this is an issue now. This is an issue now. Number one. Okay. We are handling the issue. We are upcoming. We are trying to update PDRM that how the PCA works. I think PDRM is not aware of how the PCA works. Okay. So I hope PDRM, please tag PDRM into this video. No problem. Okay. Tag PDRM into this issue, because PDRM has to know that PCA is an approval given by Singapore and has been paid about 11 to 12,000 ringgit Malaysia for them to go to work into Singapore. Okay. So this is not going to create any spread of COVID-19, because they are going to travel to Johor Bahru and going to go into Singapore. So I hope PDRM should look into this issue. It's a very, very important issue. I think PDRM should look into this issue first. The second issue is people who are coming out under emergency. Okay. People who are coming out under emergency, death cases or serious cases, you have to have minimum of at least 13,000 ringgit in your hand. The first thing is you have to apply a PCA. If you never apply PCA, then you will have to have 15,000 ringgit in your hand. Okay. Because PCA is a guarantee letter for you to go into Singapore again. Remember, if you are coming under emergency, Singapore government doesn't give a damn about y'all. They don't care. They don't care. Okay. To be very frank, to make it very, very clear, Singapore government do not care about you going for your father's funeral or mother's funeral. As far as Singapore government is concerned, you come back to Singapore, you go 21 days quarantine, and you pay for the 21 days quarantine. Okay. That is the update we have. Okay. Over the Malaysian side, we will help you to go through the DCVE. Okay. DCVE is an emergency exit into Malaysia, and for you to go for the funeral and for you to go back into Singapore. Okay. I can promise you that we will help you to go to the funeral or for the emergency cases and up to JB Custom. Okay. We can send you back up to JB Custom. We will do the arrangement. No promises. We will do the arrangement, because lately in Johor Bahru, there was lack of ambulance. Okay. There was lack of ambulance. So we have to arrange for private ambulance. We have to arrange for private vehicles. There were so many problems that we faced. Okay. But that is secondary. Okay. But some or other, we will try to make sure that the Malaysian government sends you for the emergency purpose or for the funeral that you want to attend. But for you to go into Singapore again, it's a big issue. If you do not apply PCA, hear properly what am I saying, huh? If you do not apply PCA, you would have to wait up to 10 to 14 days in Malaysia for you to go into Singapore again. Because you would have to fill up a form by ICA. ICA will reply to you in 2 days' time. They will give you a case number. And after 2 days, ICA will pass the file to MOM. MOM will take another seven days or maybe more than 1 week for them to process to give you a letter to go into Singapore. Okay. So when you go into Singapore, you still have to go through quarantine. You have to pay the money. Okay. So the process of waiting to go into Singapore will take at least 10 to 14 days. And the 10 to 14 days, you have to quarantine yourself in Malaysia, and that will also cost you about 2,100 ringgit. So before you come out from Singapore, make sure you have a PCA in your hand so that it will be easier for you to go into Singapore rather than waiting, rather than applying ICA and ICA pass it to MOM. That is a long story. Easiest way, you have money, you apply PCA, you come here, we will arrange for you DCBE, and then you just go inside back. This is the easiest way, okay? When you reach to Malaysia, you don't need to tell the Malaysian government you are under PCA. You just need to show them DCBE, okay? And when you go back into Singapore, you just need to show PCA. So, this is the safest way that you can go back into Singapore. Other than this, if you come out, you want to resign and come out, you have to go through 14 days quarantine. Let me make this very, very clear, okay? There is no more house quarantine. Even you come out on PCA, DCBE, you come out on whatever issue, no more house quarantine. Okay? You bring letters from Singapore doctors, no use. Malaysian government is not going to look into any medical record of your Singapore issue. So far, they don't see that. Okay? But you can write in into MOH. You can write in into MOH. And you can request for a home quarantine if you are disabled, if you have stroke, or maybe you just finish your operation. That is subject to approval of MHO. Okay? Besides that, you will never get any house quarantine. You mengandung ke, you whatever lah. Okay? Whatever, you are 8 months pregnant or whatever, you won't get house quarantine unless there is medical complication that is also subject to approval from CPRP or MOH. Okay? Is it very clear? Okay. Then the next thing is, whatever rumors that y'all hear about Singapore border, Singapore-Malaysian border, please check the source of the information. Y'all go to KKM website. Or the best thing, go to immigration, Jabatan Immigration Malaysian website. Check whether the WhatsApp link that y'all got, the WhatsApp message that y'all got, is it valid or not valid, okay? Because I have few people who wants to go into PCA, but PDRM have approved for them to travel. I have few cases where certain police station is not giving approval. So this is the issue that we are facing now. If you are going into Singapore again, you have a black and white letter, you are invited through PCA into Singapore, make sure that y'all have a police permit. How we already have vaccinated in Singapore. Brother, vaccine take and throw it into the dustbin. You are vaccine one time, two time, 10 times, that is nothing to do with your quarantine. You are vaccine, how many times you take the vaccine also, you have to go through quarantine. Okay? Vaccine is not an issue at all. So do not think if you have vaccination in Malaysia or in Singapore, it makes you easy to travel to both the countries. No, zero. They don't care about your vaccination. Let me be very clear. They don't care about your vaccination because looks like the vaccine is not working as what it's supposed to work. Okay, as what they arrange. Okay, this is one thing. And I'm going to talk in Tamil after this. I hope for the Singapore part, I think this is finished. Okay, I'm going to talk in Tamil. And before I talk in Tamil, I would want to request a few things to the government. Okay, the government in Malaysia, you have put a lockdown. Okay, you have put a lockdown, which is good. But looks like your lockdown is turning into a disaster again. Because we are getting lists of SOP under lockdown. Come on, Lawe. What rubbish are y'all talking? Y'all go for a full lockdown. Go for a full lockdown. You have a lockdown and you have SOP. What rubbish? Lockdown means lockdown. Nah. Y'all want to bring down the numbers or are y'all just playing games with people's life? Muhyiddin, as a prime minister, do not play games with the people's life. You want to go for a full lockdown, go for a full lockdown. Okay? Don't play games. We are looking at SOP that, you know, what I heard is JPJ, Puspacom, they all can operate. If Puspacom can operate, it means lorry drivers can bring their lorries to Puspacom. It means they can still send stuff here and there. It means companies are going to be open. It means people are going to go to work. Then what the hell are y'all telling lockdown for? I don't understand. Are y'all planning to bring down the cases, or are y'all just playing games? This is the first question to the government. The second question is, if you are going for a lockdown, where is the bantuan for the rakyat? Okay, kami nak tahu, kalau you nak lockdown satu-satu negara ni, if you want to lockdown this country, you have to give bantuan to the rakyat. Don't lockdown and y'all are rich. Y'all are rich people. Y'all don't need bantuan. But the people in B40, don't talk about B40. Even the M40 are struggling already. Mana bantuan? Mana bantuan sara hidup? I mean, mana bantuan untuk mereka yang tidak mempunyai or mereka yang mempunyai masalah kewangan? You nak lockdown, you kena ada bantuan. Dan lagi satu, where is moratorium? You need to give moratorium. Eh? If you want to go for a full lockdown, okay, the other day I told you, you go for a full lockdown, you kena bagi bantuan kepada mereka yang sedang susah, and also you have to come for moratorium. You have to give moratorium for people. Moratorium should be implemented. Okay, we need moratorium, we need bantuan, and then you go for a lockdown. Okay, if again this lockdown comes out with SOP, then screw your bloody lockdown lah, Muhyiddin. Screw yourself, screw your lockdown, screw your government, screw the entire ministers who is in Perikatan Nasional. Really, I'm telling you, this government is bringing, they are going bringing us to the drains lah. This is not the way that the government should do. This is not the way. You want to go for a lockdown, make sure you help the people. You lock down, people who got no money, what the hell you think they're going to eat, Muhyiddin? Huh? You have darurat, you have MCO 2.0, 3.0, now you bring in lockdown. I do not know what the heck you're going to call this. You bring in lockdown, and today we have a PDA format which is circling. We do not know how sure. SOP for lockdown, what the heck are y'all doing? You lockdown, then what the hell you want SOP? Lockdown means total lockdown. Go for a total lockdown. People cannot travel, but when they go to the police station, they can get approval. What is this lah? Come on lah, okay? Do not put us in more trouble, okay? KKM has taken out statement, they are running out of ICU bed. They are running out of ICU bed. Okay? And now you are bringing a lockdown and it's not going to work. Then for what the heck you are bringing a lockdown? Do not waste our time. Do not play with our life. You could be the prime minister who was not elected by the people. You could be the government who was not elected by the people. You use all these bloody frogs. Semua kata-kata untuk lompat sana, lompat sini. And you form a government. And you do not come for a live interview. You give a delay interview. That also you not tipu rakyat. Okay? And now you are not helping the rakyat. You go for a full lockdown. You give them bantuan. You give them moratorium. And then that's how you go for a full lockdown. If you think you cannot run the country, letak jawatan. Go to hell with your government. If you think you cannot perform as a prime minister, step down. In your government, Perikatan Nasional government, there's no other people capable lah. I think Najib is much better than you lah. I think if Najib come also, I think he's much better. And we have one very, very clever guy. Look at our vaccine. Do you all know why is our COVID cases increasing? Initially, they were supposed to be 75,000 people vaccinated in a day. There should be 75,000. That is what they have scheduled. 75,000 should be vaccinated a day. And do you know how many thousand which is getting vaccinated a day in our country? 25,000. We are far back behind schedule. Okay? There's only few million people who got vaccinated. And people who are supposed to get vaccinated are more than 20 over million people who are supposed to be vaccinated. 22, 23 or 24 million people who are supposed to be vaccinated. And now I think we are what, 3 million or 4 million? Or more or less, I'm not sure. We are so... What is the point? You spend so much of billions buying vaccine and you do not know how to execute. You do not know how to schedule. And it's a very sad story. இதை நான் தமிழில் தான் சொல்லி ஆகணும். இந்தியர்கள் நிறைய பேர் போய் வேக்சின் பண்ண மாட்டீங்க. ஏன் இந்தியர்கள் நிறைய பேர் போய் வேக்சின் பண்ண மாட்டீங்க? உங்க பேர் இருந்தோம் கூப்பிட்டோம், நீங்க வேக்சின் பண்ண மாட்டீங்க. ஏன் கே கமிங் பேக் டு தி டாபிக், இன் யூகே தே வேக்சினேட்டட் அக்கார்டிங் டு தி ஏஜ். தே கோ ஃபார் தி எல்டர்ஸ் பீப்பிள், ஆல் 90 இயர்ஸ் ஓல்ட் கம் வேக்சின், ஆல் 80 இயர்ஸ் ஓல்ட் கம் வேக்சின், ஆல் 70 இயர்ஸ் ஓல்ட் கம் வேக்சின். And today they have reached up to about age of 30 or something like sir. And look at the cases over there. So reduced. And look at their population. What is our population compared to China? What is our population compared to America? And yet vaccination in our country is a disaster. And Kyrie, screw yourself. You have failed. Kyrie, you can talk rubbish, okay? You could be graduate from Oxford. I'm really doubting whether you really graduate from Oxford or were you in one bloody stupid university and you claim yourself to be from Oxford. You are from Oxford. I think you have screwed up. You have got no management skill. You cannot manage. If you cannot manage, get lost. Don't put people's life in danger. Do not put people's life in danger. If it's going to be our life in danger, and if PDRM is going to arrest me for putting out this video, go to hell to PDRM. Really, I'm telling you all. Sebab ini mengenai nyawa saya. Dan nyawa keluarga saya. Dan nyawa orang yang kesayangan saya. Okay, this is something got to do with me, my family and the people who love me. If you are going to play with my life and my family's life and the people who loves me and you expect me to shut my bloody mouth, go to hell with you, Kyrie. You have failed. You have got no... You didn't manage your vaccine properly at all. To earn money, you all go and give to a local company to rebottle, to rebrand, to reprice rubbish. And yet people are not going. You all are concentrating only on buying the vaccine, spending money. But what about the management to vaccine people? Zero. Zero. Really zero. We were supposed to be at least half the people in Malaysia supposed to be vaccinated. Even if like 10 or 12 million people has been vaccinated, we are safe. Okay, we are safe. That is also, ini aku nak cakap kepada Muhyiddin, kau nak SOP, 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 bangang. SOP, salah satu SOP, haruslah semua rakyat Malaysia menerima vaksin. Penerimaan vaksin itu pun adalah satu cara untuk menurunkan COVID-19. Kau saman orang tak pakai mask sebab takut COVID merebak. Kau saman orang pasal tak keep up social distance. Kau saman orang pasal rentas negeri. Kau saman orang pasal rentas daerah. Salah satu daripada perkara yang penting, okay, untuk COVID-19 itu daripada merebak adalah untuk memberi vaccination kepada semua orang. Kau gagal. Siapa nak saman kau, Muhyiddin? Kerajaan kau gagal untuk... Kau tengok sudah berapa lama sekarang. You know how many months is it? It has been taken, you know? Months has been taken but still people are not vaccinated. This is one of the cause the COVID is so high. Jadi kita sekarang rakyat, kita nak saman kerajaan ini boleh ke? Boleh tak kami saman kerajaan ini? Kita tak pakai SOP, kau saman. Kau takut COVID merebak. Kau tak vaksin orang pun COVID merebak. Siapa nak saman kau? Ha? Dalam kau merayau tak pakai mask. Ha? Berapa banyak gambar ada tak pakai mask? Ha? Kita harus ada satu undang-undang di mana kalau orang politik yang mempunyai kuasa, terutamanya yang berada di kerajaan, tak ikut SOP, gantung kerja diorang. Kau nak ajar orang untuk ikut SOP, kau sendiri tak ikut SOP. Ha? Dalam SOP kau SOP bangang. What rubbish SOP? One of the, kau masukkan yang semua orang harus dapatkan vaccination. By now, Khairi should be sacked from the government. Khairi harus ditendang keluar sebagai menteri untuk menjaga vaksin ini. Dia sudah gagal. Khairi has failed. Khairi sudah gagal. Ini adalah satu kesalahan yang tidak boleh dipandang remeh. Ini adalah satu kegagalan yang puncanya, salah satu puncanya, kenaikan COVID begitu tinggi di negara kita. This is one of the reason you didn't vaccine properly, people. Huh? You screw up your vaccination program. Ini adalah satu kegagalan besar. Siapa nak saman Khairi? Kau gunakan wang rakyat untuk beli vaksin. Kau simpan vaksin. Kau tak betul-betul schedulekan vaksin itu macam mana. You fail to give the people vaccine in limited time. By now, at least 12 million or 13 million people should be vaccinated. But you fail. Who is going to take action for you to fail? Siapa yang akan ambil tindakan atas Khairi ini yang telah gagal untuk memberi vaksin kepada sekurang-kurangnya 50% rakyat Malaysia yang who can take vaccine? Because out of 32 million people in Malaysia, not everyone is eligible for vaccine. Younger children are not eligible. So I think it's about 25 million or something around that people only which are eligible to take vaccine. Huh? We want the government to take action against Khairi for failing. Kalau tak ambil tindakan, kalau COVID ini masih merebak, I do not know what to say lah. Really, I do not know what to say. Y'all are talking rubbish. Ada vaksin di tangan, kenapa begitu lambat untuk bagi kat orang? Huh? What is the problem? What went wrong? Khairi senang. Khairi gagal. Khairi gagal. Khairi gagal. Khairi gagal. Apa yang kau janji kepada rakyat, kau tak tunaikan. Apa yang telah dijanjikan kepada rakyat tak ditunaikan. Jadi kau gagal. Resign and go. Give it to a better person. Kau nak duduk dalam kerajaan. Kerajaan itu nak. You all want to stay as a government. Stay. But sack Khairi. Bring in people who can work. We don't want people who can talk Oxford English. We don't want people who can talk British English. Talk like rubbish. Talk as of you all. You own the entire world. But bila nak buat kerja, lembab. And if you're going to say I cannot voice out for myself, I do not know. I will sue this bloody government. Really, I'm telling you. I will sue this government. Kalau saya tak boleh bersuara untuk diri saya dengan keluarga saya sebab masih tak dapat vaksin, okay? Kalau you orang nak tangkap saya, go ahead. Saya akan saman semua orang. I will sue. We have the rights. We have the rights to question. The vaccine was bought with our money. Not your grandfather's money. The vaccine was bought with our money. We are supposed to receive the vaccine by certain period of time. Now the government has delayed. Siapa nak saman kerajaan untuk memberi vaksin yang lambat ini? Who is going to sue the government? I hope someone sue this bloody government. Millions, maybe billions. Setiap orang yang meninggal dunia akibat COVID-19 dan tidak menerima vaksin ini harus saman kerajaan ini. Harus saman kerajaan ini.
Bukan saja orang yang meninggal, orang yang sekarang masuk ICU keluar pun, kamu mempunyai hak untuk saman kerajaan ini sebab tidak memberi vaksin kepada kamu sampai hari ini. I think if they would have given us also, I think we could have done it much better than this government lah. Really, I'm telling you. Poor management, filthy rich government, 70 over ministers. Do you know, if y'all have 70 over ministers, I do not know whether the normal people can understand or no. Do you know 70 over ministers? Do you know how many SUSK they have or no? SUSK is like equal to their post, you know. How many SUSK they have to pay? How many PA per minister will have at least 2 to 3 PAs paid by the government? Do you know how much of millions they are? I am going to talk to my lawyer anyway. I will talk to my lawyer. Kepada sesiapa yang meninggal dunia akibat COVID-19 ini, dan kalau dia tidak menerima vaksin, itu adalah salah satu punca kematian dia mungkin adalah sebab dia tak dapat vaksin. Okay, then I think someone has to sue this government. Kalau tak apalah, tak menang waktu government ini berada sekarang, mungkin kita tak menang, tak apalah, pilihan raya nanti, we know what to do. Waktu tu jagalah korang. Pity, I'm looking at the cases. What rubbish is going on? Okay, coming back to the Singapore, I'm going to talk in Tamil. Tamil la pesren. Okay, Tamil la pesren. Marubadiya solren. Singapore la irundhu veliya avringa. Seriya, veliya avumbodhu eduva irundhalum call pannunga. Call, you can call Permas number. Seriya, innonu vandhu. நிறைய ஜாமா நம்ம கிட்ட இருக்கு இப்ப. ஸோ கெடால வந்து ஜாமா கொடுத்துக்கிட்டு இருக்கோம், செலவு ஜாமா கெடால பஹாங்ல மிளக்குல. இன்னைக்கு தான் வந்து டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட், இன்னும் போய் கொடுக்கல, ஆனால் இன்னைக்கு தான் பிரிச்சிருக்கோம். அதனால தான் இப்படி இருக்கிறேன் நான். ஸோ இன்னைக்கு தான் உட்காந்து ஜாமாலாம் அடுக்கி ஜாமாலாம் பிரிச்சுக்கிட்டு இருக்கோம். ஸோ போக வேண்டிய ஸ்டேட்டுக்கெல்லாம் ஜாமா போய்கிட்டு தான் இருக்கு. அநேகமாக இன்னொரு 2-3 நாள் வந்து கஷ்டப்படுறவங்களுக்கு வந்து இந்த ஜாமா போய் சேர்ந்துடும். அந்த மாதிரி அரேஞ்ச் பண்ணியிருக்கோம். அரிசி மூட்டை எண்ணெய் சீனி இந்த மாதிரி நிறைய ஜாமான் அரேஞ்ச் பண்ணி வச்சுருக்கோம். எல்லா ஸ்டேட்டுக்கும் வந்து நான் வந்து ரொம்ப கஷ்டப்படுறவங்கள போய் பார்க்க சொல்லியிருக்கேன். ஏன்னா எல்லா ஸ்டேட்லேயும் இப்போ ஒற்றுமை நம்பளம் டீம் இருக்குது ஃபுல்லாக, எவ்ரி ஸ்டேட். திஸ் இஸ் நோ ஜோக். கெடா, பினாங், ஈப்போலேருந்து, நகரி சிம்லான்லேருந்து, மிளாக்கா, பஹாங், ஜோஹோ, எல்லா ஸ்டேட்லேயும் வந்து ஒற்றுமை நம்பளம் டீம் இப்போ இருக்குது. அண்ட் எல்லா ஸ்டேட்டுக்கும் வந்து பிரித்து எல்லாமே கொடுத்தாச்சு. இல்லை, பிரித்து போய்கிட்டு இருக்கு. கொஞ்சம் ஸ்டேட்டுக்கு போயிட்டு இருக்கு. கொஞ்சம் ஸ்டேட் வந்து தூரமாக இருக்கிறதுனால பணமாக நம்ம அனுப்பிட்டோம். ஸோ அவங்க அங்கே வாங்கிடுவாங்க. ஸோ உங்களுக்கு வந்து வீட்டில் வந்து பொருட்கள் இல்லாட்டினா யால் கேன் கால் அஸ், நம்ம வந்து அரேஞ்ச் பண்ணுவோம் உங்களுக்கு ஜாமான் அரிசிலாம் இல்லாட்டினா. ஸோ தயவு செஞ்சு உண்மையிலே உங்களுக்கு காசு இல்லைன்னா நீங்கள் வாங்க, கண்டிப்பாக உங்களுக்கு ஜாமான் வந்து சேர்ற மாதிரி நாங்கள் பார்க்குறோம். அது ஒன்று. ஜாமா கொடுக்கணும்னு விருப்பப்படுறவங்க தயவு செஞ்சு நான் சொல்கிற ஃபோன் நம்பருக்கு வந்து கால் பண்ணுங்கள், வாட்ஸ்அப் பண்ணுங்கள். உங்களுக்கு நீங்கள் ஜாமா கொடுக்கறதா இருந்தாலும் ஓகே, கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன் பண்ணுறதா இருந்தாலும், ஜாமா வாங்கி கொடுத்தாலும் நம்மளுக்கு பெரிய நல்ல நல்ல விஷயமா இருக்கும். சரியா? ஸோ நீங்கள் கால் பண்ண வேண்டிய பார்க்குறவங்க தயவு செஞ்சு என்னோடய அட்மின்ஸ் இல்லாட்டி பார்க்குறவங்க யாராச்சும் வந்து என் நம்பரை போட்டுருங்க. நீங்கள் கால் பண்ண வேண்டிய வாட்ஸ்அப் பண்ண வேண்டிய நம்பர் வந்து 017-50-11-044. மறுபடியும் சொல்கிறேன், 017-50-11-044. இந்த நம்பருக்கு வந்து நீங்கள் வாட்ஸ்அப் பண்ணுங்கள். கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன் நீங்கள் என்ன ஜாமா கொடுக்க போகிறீங்கன்னு சொல்லுங்கள், ஜாமா எங்கே இருக்குன்னு சொல்லுங்கள், நாங்கள் சொல்கிறோம். எந்த ஸ்டேட்டாக இருந்தாலும் நீங்கள் கொடுக்கலாம். சரியா? எந்த ஸ்டேட்டாக இருந்தாலும் நீங்கள் கொடுக்கலாம். ஏன்னா நம்ம வந்து மலேசியாவில் இருக்கிற ஃபுல்லாக எல்லா இந்தியர்களுக்கும் நாங்கள் வந்து உதவி செய்கிறதுக்கு வந்து ஜாமா வந்து ரெடி பண்ணிக்கிட்டு இருக்கோம். ஃபுல்லாக கெடாலேருந்து ஜோஹோபார் வரைக்கும் ஃபுல்லாக எல்லா இந்தியர்களுக்கும் வந்து முடிஞ்ச அளவுக்கு, நம்மளால் முடிஞ்ச அளவுக்கு வந்து ஜாமா வந்து அனுப்பி வச்சுக்கிட்டு இருக்கோம். இப்போ அநேகமாக நாளைக்கு நாளைக்கு கொடுக்க ஆரம்பிச்சிருவோம். சரியா? ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் காய்ஸ், நீங்க ஜாமா கொடுக்கறதா இருந்தா ப்ளீஸ் உங்ககிட்ட கூட ஜாமா அஞ்சு பேக்கெட் அரிசியா இருந்தாலும் பரவாயில்ல ஒரு பாக்ஸ் எண்ணெயா இருந்தாலும் பரவாயில்ல எனி திங் வி நீட் அ லாட் ஆஃப் ஐட்டம்ஸ் சரிங்களா நன்றி வணக்கம் இந்த வீடியோவை தயவு செஞ்சு ஷேர் பண்ணுங்க பார்த்துட்டு சும்மா இருக்காதீங்க ஷேர் பண்ணுங்க நீங்க ஷேர் பண்ண தான் நிறைய பேருக்கு விளங்கும் என்ன நடக்குதுன்னு சரியா நன்றி வணக்கம்